Longitudinal joints are prone to early deterioration, so using Echelon paving to reduce the number of these joints can be beneficial. During Echelon paving, two or more paving trains work side by side to lay asphalt. The second machine places hot asphalt against the uncompacted hot mat of the first machine. This requires large amounts of planning. The edges between adjacent lanes are hot and the mats blend, creating a stronger bond and ensuring uniform density. Hot joints from Echelon paving perform better over the long term compared to cold joints and usually result in similar density in the joint as the mat. A constraint during Echelon paving is the mix production rate and equipment needed to supply multiple pavers. If there isn't enough hot asphalt for simultaneous paving, the material cools, making the process similar to regular paving. Insufficient supply can also result in start-stop behavior and smoothness issues. When paving an Echelon, each paver should be no more than 100 feet behind the paver in front of it so the mats can weld themselves together before the mix on either side of the joint cools. The side gate of the trailing paver should overlap the mat of the lead paver by about 1 inch. Each lane should have an entire paving train to ensure proper placement and adequate compaction. To help achieve optimal density at the hot joint, one effective approach is for the breakdown roller behind the first paver to leave about 4 to 6 inches of the joint unrolled. The breakdown roller following the second paver can then compact this joint on its first pass. Echelon paving ensures that hot asphalt mats blend seamlessly, creating stronger bonds and uniform density. This results in more durable, long-lasting pavement.